I just would like to make one comment. The, quote, ethics and lobbying reform bill will be coming to the floor of the Senate later this week. It has a lot of good things in it and some important reforms, but the fundamental problem in Washington remains the earmarks and reform of the earmark process, which has led to so much corruption, is simply not addressed, and certainly not in a meaningful fashion. So I'll be opposing the legislation, not on the grounds that it doesn't have much needed reforms, but it doesn't reform the earmark process, which has led to corruption and members of Congress going to jail. And until we fix that, we're not going to fix the corruption problem in Washington, and we're not going to restore the confidence of the American people in the Congress and their government. Questions?
Why is this area so important to you?
Ohio remains a battleground state, and it's historically true, and I think will be true in 2008, that Ohio will play the key role in the selection of the President of the United States as it has in the past.
Is this more important to your campaign than others? You're here a good little bit.
Well, I've spent a lot of time in the state campaigning for candidates, and so I think I can do well here, but I don't know how other candidates will do. But a glance at history shows that Ohio is the heartland of America, and almost always the candidate from either party that carries the state of Ohio wins the presidency.
There's been a lot written about your campaign and funding, and you're here for a fundraiser tonight. Mm-hmm. What can you tell us about the campaign funding?
I can tell you that our campaign's in good shape. We've made some changes, and I'm happy with the political and financial base that we have, and I'm very happy to be back here in Ohio where there's lots of money.
Money and friends.
I just would like to say, Mike DeWine, I spent a great deal of time here in the last election campaigning for him and other candidates, and I've been here a lot. Go ahead.
Oh, people were asking if do you have the money to go the distance?
Oh, sure. Yeah, our money's coming in fine. We've cut our budget. It wasn't so much the money coming in, it was the money going out, and we have reduced those expenses dramatically, and we're doing fine.
So you do plan to stay until the end?
I never had any thought of otherwise, and we'll win. I can out-campaign any of the other people in the race. I know how to do the town hall meetings, and we'll be campaign our competitors, I'm sure. And more importantly, I'm the candidate who's fully prepared to take on the struggle against radical Islamic extremism. My background, my knowledge, and my vision qualifies me over any other candidate on either side.
Some polls have suggested that your stance on the war has resulted in the below fundraising. Where do you go from here?
Well, my stance on the war in some parts of the country is more acceptable than others. The point is, though, I know what's right for America. I know what will happen if we agree with the Democrats and set a date for withdrawal. It'll be chaos and genocide, and more American sacrifice will be entailed if we surrender as the Democrats want us to do. And so I have no other choice, no matter what impact it might have on my political ambitions. I would much rather, as I've said several times, I would much rather lose a campaign than lose a war.
It's a long way off from Iowa, but right now you're polling around 10% in Iowa, which is at the bottom. How do you plan to turn that around?
Well, we have much higher numbers than that in other polls. You're citing one poll. We're doing fine.
The National Journal has you fourth among Republicans.
I'm not too concerned about the National Journal. I've had town hall meetings all over Iowa, and we're doing fine there.
Why did you choose not to participate in the Ames straw poll?
Because we thought it was a waste of time and money.
Okay. That shouldn't be taken as a sign at all that you're nervous about the... Your name's still going to be on the ballot, I understand.
It doesn't matter to me. I know that Rudy Giuliani decided not to compete, as well as many others didn't. Straw polls, in my political experience, are meaningless. It's a great fundraiser for the party. But
I read something recently about your boxing career as well, too. Yeah, so you know something a bit about being an underdog as well?
Yeah, and I've had much tougher weeks in my life than any I've experienced in this political campaign.
Mm-hmm. Senator, there seems to be a whole lot of talk now about partitioning in Iraq. Mm-hmm. And as a potential solution mm-hmm. here. What do you see that? The potential for that, given the political situation on the ground there now?
Well, what I saw a couple of days ago was Iraqis unified and together and celebrating an Iraqi victory in a soccer match. It's obvious that Iraqis are Iraqis first. A partition of Iraq, as some would envision, I think, shows a fundamental misunderstanding of the country and the region. If there was a partition, the Turks have said they will not allow an independent Kurdish state, so the Turks would invade. That's what they say, not me.
But soccer is one thing.
Pardon
oil,
me?
Soccer is one thing. Oil is, and those kind of issues are another, aren't they?
I don't I don't know how you divide Baghdad by bedrooms. There's Sunni and Shia who are married to each other. There's 2 million Sunni and 4 million Shia in Baghdad. There's no way you could partition that. So Saudi Arabia would be concerned about Sunni. There would be chaos in the region, and partitions don't work. So I just strongly disagree with the idea that you're going to partition a country when I know from my experience that people feel they are Iraqis first, Sunni, Shia, or Kurd second.
In Ohio, there's a record number of foreclosures in people's homes. I mean, this is something, in my own neighborhood, I know a number of people are having to move out of their houses.
Yes.
They've gotten caught up in a couple of different things. I mean,
yes.
This is a very bottom line. I mean, to people who, live the everyday working Joe,
yes.
Walmart may be doing great. Box stores may be doing great, but my neighbors are going, I'm moving out of my house.
I understand.
What can you do for these folks?
I think the best thing you can do for them is to make sure that there are training and education programs. The federal programs have failed for displaced workers. There are workers who are displaced by foreign competition in Ohio, Illinois, Pennsylvania, Michigan, and there are empty homes in those states. We need to have a good, robust training and education program run by the community colleges. The community colleges have the wherewithal to train and educate people for local jobs and those opportunities. We can't keep leaving people behind as we have done as a result of this information technology change we have experiencing.
A lot of the people are still working. It's just that their money isn't going far enough to pay for the house. And, they've quit a lot of the things. I mean, you give up a lot of things before you give up your house.
Yeah.
The money, the dollar just isn't going as far as it used to.
Well, my understanding of most of the problems are associated with job displacement because of foreign competition, whether it be the automobile industry or whether it be other manufacturing jobs in Ohio that have left. And I think we ought to make people eligible for better jobs, better paying jobs, and a better future rather than jobs that are fleeing overseas.
It's pretty well known that Cincinnati and Hamilton County are pretty good Republicans. How critical of a part of your campaign is this area going to be for you achieving the Republican nomination?
I think it's very important. I think any nominee who carries this part of the state is going to win. But second of all, candidates have to know that this is where the voter-rich area is, and it's probably a very important part of the state. I know of no candidate who's been able to carry the nomination that didn't carry a statewide Ohio candidate that didn't carry strongly this part of the state.
Do you plan on being back here a lot then?
I intend to be back as much as possible. It's a beautiful place to visit.
What about Kentucky? We're actually standing in Kentucky at this point.
Well, Kentucky obviously is going to be an important state as well. But in all due respect, and I appreciate Kentucky, we all know that Ohio is viewed as the heartland of America. It has been critical in every presidential race in recent history, and all states are important, but Ohio is known as the heartland of America. I mean, that's just a fact, and I don't mean to denigrate any other state in America, including my own.
What's Mike DeWine been able to do for you?
Mike's still highly regarded, particularly in the Republican Party and among some of our supporters as well as fundraisers, and he's a very dear friend. We've been dear friends for many, many years, and I miss him every day, and I mean no disrespect to his successor.
How's your health? You've had a couple of issues over the years.
It's fine.
How are you doing?
It's fine. Fine. I keep work 24/7. I try to bring my 95-year-old mother with me wherever I go.
There you go. Any concern about Chief Justice John Roberts and his health?
Yeah, I think we ought to know a little more about that. I just, you know, they said it was benign, but I hope we find out more information on it. But I don't know any more than what I've read in the media. So, thanks for coming out, and thanks for taking the time. And I'm sorry for dragging you all the way out here. Thank you. It's good to see you.
Thank you. Appreciate you taking time out.
It's good to see you. Thanks again.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.